Welcome everyone! Electrotechnical University International team is speaking. This is the first introductory webinar of our university. So, what we will be dealing with today? First of all, let me introduce myself. My name is Sandra Kilina. I am the head of preparatory department. And please welcome my colleagues who will be with us today. Our head of International Students Office, Mr. Renat Yalashev. The managers of International Students Office, Ms. Maria Titorenko and Ms. Daria Uverskaya. Our tutor, Anna Kongurova, manager of summer and winter schools, Nika Domanova. And our speakers, Professor Assistant Anton Filatov and Head of Technological Forecasting Center, Alexandra Proshkina. And at first, I would like to show you a quite short video about our university.
Deciding on your future isn't easy. The options are endless, and the decision should be yours, not everyone else's.
You have to get a real job.
And who are you going to be?
Are you wearing that?
You don't read enough.
When I was your age.
Slow down and think, will you?
You're so distracted by all this technology.
Kids these days.
Don't talk back.
Don't even think about it. Don't you dare.
The internet is a waste. That's nonsense. You're too young to understand. We know better.
LETI, a university that won't decide for you. Here you can make your own choices. You can try new ideas, spark new passions, pursue wild dreams, seek, find, experiment, learn, and master. There's so much waiting for you here. LETI gives you the chance to choose. Experience the freedom of learning for you.
We will start with some information from our girls, Anna and Nika. I have heard that they prepared something for you. Girls?
Hi, I'm Anna. Nice to see you.
Hi, I'm Nika. Hope you're all doing well.
We're here to shed some light on a program that is waiting for you today.
Something very curious is up ahead. Could you guess what it is?
Even if you have some ideas, I can't wait to share with you.
Don't rush. We will take it nice and slow.
You're right. Let's start.
Friends, now we are going to have two lectures from our speakers. At the end of these lectures, you are going to participate in a quiz.
It should be interesting. To enjoy, if you should listen to speakers carefully, because questions relate to the materials.
It's better to listen to them very attentively, because the winners of the quiz will receive prizes.
You see, we told you before that we will have some fun today.
Yes. So, come on, let's talk more about the prizes.
Do you know that Electrotechnical University provides seasonal schools?
Yes, for example, we have English taught seasonal schools that happen both in July and in January.
We also have the schools of the Russian language that we have in July, in August and in January. And you have an opportunity to visit them.
But to visit these schools and to visit St. Petersburg, you will have to win the quiz. And to do that, you have to listen to the speakers. And let us transition to the speakers.
Enjoy it!
How interesting! And there will be some presents. Okay, now I would like to pass the word to Professor Assistant Anton Filatov. Anton?
Hello everyone. My report will be about the laboratory that we have in our university. I am from Department of Software Engineering and Computer Application, and here in LETI, we have built the laboratory that is called DuckTown. What is it? So basically here on the right picture, you can see the photo of our laboratory. We built it to model the behavior of self-driving cars. Here in our department, we explore a lot of different projects. We research a lot of different projects, but one of them is the modeling of self-driving cars. We are not the pioneers in this area. Originally, the Ducky Town appeared in MIT University in USA about maybe 10 or maybe a bit lower, maybe 6 years ago. But now, in this year, we have built it in our university. And let me describe what is it, how does it work, and what we can do with this laboratory with the students. If you have some questions, you can interrupt me. Unfortunately, I don't see the chat because of my full screen demonstration. If there would be some questions that I don't see, I will answer them after the report. So, what is a Ducky Town? A Ducky Town is basically simply the carpet with the marks that can be understood as the road signs, traffic lights, traffic signs, other boards, even pedestrians. The ducks on our Ducky Town are the pedestrians. And our focus is to make the robots that are equipped with something, I'll explain a bit further, they have to behave as the self-driving cars. Talking about the self-driving cars, it is important to say how is it working in the real life on the real self-driving cars. So basically, we have six levels of autonomy, from 0 to 5. From the level where we have absolutely no autonomy, where all the features are done by the human. And to the fifth level, where that you could see in the science fiction movies, where all the cars can move without any human interaction. And the most interesting are the four levels in the middle, where the first level is the parktronic, cruise control, and other assistance features in the car that are already equipped, installed, also almost in every car. On the second level of autonomy is the partial automation, where the car can accelerate, it can stop, it can maybe a little bit steer to maybe keep in lane or maybe to switch lanes on the highway. But on the second level of autonomy, we are not sure if the self-driving car can come through the road intersection. And the sad spoiler is that the current state of the self-driving cars is level 2. Of course, you could see the videos, for example, of Tesla cars, of Toyota cars, of Uber cars, who could come through the intersection, who could successfully drive from the point E to point B on the map, and they could understand where are the cars and maybe even communicate with them. But the sad reality is that we cannot rely that every moment on the road would be correctly computated by the self-driving car. So the idea is that all these videos may be proof that these cars are on the level 3. But since we don't have any law for self-driving cars, since we cannot say that in every moment, in night, in day, or in winter or summer, if we cannot be sure that for every condition the self-driving car can realize the correct calculate the correct behavior, we cannot we cannot state that we are at a level 3 of autonomy. And our laboratory is also can work only on the level 2. The fourth level is the level that is much closer to the fifth level, where the human might not even monitor the environment. It can give the opportunity to the car to make the decisions and just maybe go to sleep or to read a book and so on. I hope that somewhere in the future, maybe in 50 years or in 100 years, we will achieve this level of autonomy, but it's definitely not today. All right, back to our ducky town. So the real autopilots, real self-driving cars, should be equipped with as much sensors as possible. Cameras, GPS navigators, lidars, sonars, radars, maybe some other weird sensors. But for our little model in our ducky town, our robots are equipped only with the camera. So basically, the simplest equipment of the robot is the camera, small computation model Raspberry Pi, driver model Arduino, wheel drivers that are not seen in the photo, but they exist, wheels and battery. And basically, that is all to model very close to the real autopilot behavior. Let me explain in a couple of words how does it work. So basically, the ducky bot observes the environment with the camera, and it should give the commands to the wheel how it should move. Yes, it should take all the decisions. How does it work? Let's go step by step for every solution that is implemented in the ducky bot, and you will see how many things you have to know to program these robots. First of all, we have to make the rectification of the image. So basically, since we use the only one camera, this camera should have the wide angle of view. And this leads the, I don't really know correct terms in English. Well, we can see that some lines that should be straight are not really straight, and we have to fix it. And there appears first step when we apply complex math. It requires a bit knowledge to know how to transform this image to this one. But it's beginning, but not the end. We can do this rectification with the calibration of intrinsic calibration with calibration of intrinsic parameters. Those of you who had worked already with computer vision, you might saw this pattern, this chess pattern for calibration. Those who haven't, well, let me introduce the pattern for calibration most cameras in the world. If you are working with some robots that should observe the environment with cameras, the first step you do, you calibrate the camera with this or the same to this pattern. This allows to bring, as I've shown on the previous slide, this brings the rectification and calculation of some, for example, of some parameters, for example, focus distance and so on. There are, as far as I remember, 9 intrinsic parameters in every camera. Next step, after we did something that is not connected to the ducky bot at all, when we just calibrated the camera, we have to find our position in the lane. We as humans can see that here we see the white lane, here we see the yellow lane. So basically, we have to keep the white lane on the right side and the left lane on the left side. We as a human understand it correctly. How can we as a bot understand this? Well, the easiest solution is to find the straight lines and distract them by colors. So basically, in this video, you can see all the white lines that are extracted on the video, on the frame, and the white line and the yellow lines. So the white lines are marked with the black lines and the yellow with the blue lines. You see that this color segmentation, almost segmentation, is almost correct. You see that there are a lot of errors, for example, here or here, or even in the yellow line, we sometimes see white. Well, yes, this is the research area. This is the place where we have not the 100% working solution. And maybe if you will, in the future, choose our laboratory, our university, and appear in this project, maybe you will face the similar problem, like color segmentation. Let's assume that we have successfully found every lane on the image. then we have to find how far are these images from the bot. This is another part of the calibration where we have to understand how our camera is rotated in the 3D space. We also use the calibration patterns for these purposes, and this is already solved task where there is no magic. So basically, the existing math allows us to find the distance to any object by two pictures. And taking these two pictures allows us to understand the shape of our bot and the distance to any point on the map. The next point is to when we understood all the lanes on the image, when we understood how far every point from this lane to our camera, we have to understand how are we oriented in the lane. So basically, it is done by detecting the detecting of orientation of each line. You saw on that image, I will go two or three slides back. You can see on this image that we can understand, looking at these images on their angle on the two-dimensional space, we can understand how are they oriented according to our area of view. There also comes some math that allows us to calculate the distance from the middle of the road and the angle of the road if we assume that all the lines are understood correctly, are calculated correctly. There might appear some noise of calculation, there might appear some noise of observations, and we have to deal with it. We have to apply more filters, more math to fix it. Well, this is another research area. After we understood where are we located in the how are we oriented on the road, we have to take a decision how we have to move. Do we want to move forward or we want to rotate, and so on. For these purposes, we use the controllers. Maybe somebody of you are familiar with the PID regulators, proportional integrative derivative regulator. Well, this is another point of math that you have to know before you apply it. Basically, this is just one formula that converts one parameters to another, but this formula has a lot of different parameters, different calibration parameters that leads to a different result. So basically, how to rotate if we understood that we are in the wrong position is also the researching open question. The last, but not the least, part that we have to do is to convert our idea how we should move forward and rotate. V is the linear velocity, omega is the angular velocity. We have to convert these two float numbers to the particular power that we put on every wheel driver. The Ducky bot are simple and they have only two wheels, and the rotation is happening with the difference of the speed rotation of each wheel. If we rotate one wheel faster than another, we will rotate on the one place. So basically, for this model of the robot, this transformation is straightforward, and there might only appear the noise of the wheel drivers. Even two similar wheel drivers might behave in different ways with the same electricity power. And we have to deal with it. We have to maybe calibrate some parameters for every particular robot. So here we can sum up every step that should be done by the robot to process one particular image. And good camera should provide 30 images per second, and we have to process 30 images per second. So basically, we balance here between the accuracy and speed, and sometimes we lose this battle. But in general, this almost worked fine. Unfortunately, I didn't prepare the video how does it work in general, but I can assure you that in 50% of time, we don't break the law by changing the lane and coming through the intersection. Another 50% are the parts where we have to apply the research area, where we have to come up with new solutions that are not even exist maybe right now, or they exist but not applicable. So what? So I explained to you in a couple of words how the behavior of the bot works, and the last question is to answer is so what we can do with this. So basically, this is the Ducky Town is the good model of the self-driving cars. Everything that is working for the real self-driving cars should work for the Ducky Bots. Everything that works for the Ducky Bots should work for the self-driving cars, with some restrictions, of course, but the general approaches are the same. And we can use this polygon for testing the existing solutions. Another thing that I have already told about is the researching area. It is much cheaper to apply the source code for the little bots, that may be like this size, rather than to apply to the real self-driving car and to see that for some reasons it's accelerating in the wall. To fix a robot is cheaper. Another point is that we can use this polygon for studying, because once again, giving to a student a real self-driving car is much more dangerous than giving it a little robot. Of course, losing a robot is also sad news, but it's much better than losing a big grown-up car. And last but not least, we can use, and we use this polygon for cost contests. We have already performed one cost contest in the last autumn, and in this year we also would like to collaborate with our colleagues from Canada that also have a similar polygon, and we can provide the worldwide contests for the model of self-driving cars. All right, that is it I wanted to tell you about. So if you have some questions, please don't hesitate to ask.
Our next guest is Head of Technological Forecasting Center, Alexandra Proshkina. Alexandra, please.
Yeah, thank you too much. Hello, everybody. And now I'm going to tell you about one of the most innovative faculties in our university, and it's called the Institute of Innovation, Design and Technological Entrepreneurship in ProTech. Now I'd like to show my presentation. Okay, so can you hear, can you see it? I hope you can do so. As I previously said, I'll tell you about Institute of Innovation Design and Technological Entrepreneurship in our university. So our institute is based on the Faculty of Economics and Management, and considering courses related to economics and management mixed with technological entrepreneurship and innovative management, we decided to establish such institute, which is responsible for preparing the specialists in the sphere of innovative management and future technological entrepreneurs. And concerning this, we can speak about our faculty in two ways. So one direction is science and education part, and another one is innovation and entrepreneurship direction. If we are speaking about science and education here, you can get a bachelor or master degree, finishing one of the programs established here in quality management or technological innovation management. And during education in our institute, you can choose some courses related to entrepreneurship, and you're also able to perform your startup project within the performing your bachelor or master degree. If you are not ready to become a technological entrepreneur, you can get you can get some knowledge in sphere of innovation management, and our graduates are working for well-known international companies. You can see these companies on the slide. And to be honest, now due to the fact of digitalization, our specialists are required in different spheres, not only in the companies established, but also in the sphere of IT technology and the sphere of even medicine science, because you know that nowadays medicine science is also a required sphere of interest. So it was, what about our education programs? And as I understand, you can ask my colleagues or you can write down your questions via chat about the educational project, educational process. And now I'd like to tell you about another part of education in our institute, and it is related to the innovation and entrepreneurship. And during performing one of bachelor or master degree in our institute, you can be involved in the activities related to entrepreneurship. We are participating in activities of our case laboratory, or doing some tech forecasts for our center of tech forecast entrepreneurship, or just by doing your own project, your own startup, and getting support from our project investment office. So to be more specific, if we are speaking about your activity in case laboratory, here I'd like to tell you that you have to use your knowledge, your skills to perform the task which is called engineering case. So the cases are based on the company's data, companies from real sector of our economics. It means energy sector or gas or oil sector. And so you have to perform some task related to the innovation activity of such companies and our partners, these companies from the well-established sectors, will estimate your results. And of course, if the result is quite satisfying, you can get an opportunity to enter this company or try to get some scholarship or some presents. For example, I know previously it was like an iPhone and so on. So our main goal in involving you in this activity is to develop your soft skills, first of all, develop your skills of working in team, and of course, to push you to think in innovative way on how to perform sometimes usual task in innovative way. So if you are ready to take part in our case competitions, so of course we welcome you, and we will try to include you in a team for performing such task. So another part of our institute in innovative and entrepreneurship direction, it is our network project. And here I'd like to tell you about such projects like Startup as a Diploma, first of all, because it's a unique opportunity in Russia. And from 2019, this initiative is becoming more established in University of Russia. And our university also decided to take part in this project. And our students have an opportunity to prepare their own startup and to lay the idea of startup in a master or graduate thesis. And for such project, startup as a diploma, our students prepare thesis in some unusual way. I mean, the requirements to such diploma varies. If we compare it with usual way of preparing the thesis, but our main challenge in this project is to help you to prepare your own startup, to develop it, and to find the investors for startup. Because after presenting your graduate thesis, we also try to organize some pitch sessions or some meetings with potential investors. So for us, your startup is not only as a project for diploma, but also the project that could be realized and could be presented in the market. Another project related with your entrepreneurship activities, because as I previously said, we tend to develop your entrepreneur skills. So here we can tell about some competitions for young entrepreneurship. And in Russia here, there are a lot of some kind of competitions in this way. And I'm proud that our team, team of our university, including the students of Institute for Innovation, Design, and Technological Entrepreneurship, they won a national competition for young entrepreneurship. And you can see on the slide the idea of the startup that was presented, and this idea won the support from the national competition. And if the entrepreneurship, our young entrepreneurship decides, of course, they can realize and put it in the market. So the idea was related to the application, mobile application, Pocket Guide, which will help our tourists to visit sightseeing in St. Petersburg. And I don't want to tell the peculiarity of this application, because it's a startup and it's now getting the some positive response from the audience. So if you are interested in this project, of course you can find some information about it in open sources. And concerning all the initiatives preparing startups and developing entrepreneurial skills of our students, we also launch the startup accelerator, and this is called ETU Route. And now we finished the technical side of this startup accelerator, and from September we tend to establish it to the wide audience, and we will get our first projects for startup accelerator. In the future, of course, we think that the projects that will that we can get from startup accelerator also would be presented as the project of startup as a diploma. So here you can see some connection between both projects, and finally we have to push our students in a way of thinking more innovative and thinking about how to solve some problems of our maybe companies or problems from our market. And solving these problems, you can find some unique idea which helps to establish your own startup project. And Also, we do not mind, of course, of including our students in international activity, because we support the participating in some international projects, and taking into account previous information, you can understand that we are ready to connect with our international partners. You can see from Norway, Germany, Nigeria, and Italy. With partners from these countries, we already have the experience in performing some international projects in a way of developing startups and participating in some competitions. But we're also ready to extend this list of partners. And if you are ready to involve, of course, so you can get your idea to our startup accelerator, and then we will develop it here in Russia or in your country, if we can find the partner. And also, our department is responsible for organizing an international scientific conference, and it is called Young Engineers in Energy Sector. This conference will take part in December 2029, and here the world known professors all over the world will discuss the future of energy sector, not only in Russia, but also in other countries, in a way how young engineers can find their own place in the energy sector of the future. And also here we are ready to discuss the partnership with different countries and with other universities, and in order to involve as more countries as it could be. So if you also find your knowledge in this sphere to be interesting, so we can think about your participation in such conference. So I think I told you about the most innovative sides of our institute, and now I'm ready to answer your question via chat or here or in the end of our session.
Thank you, Alexandra. That was interesting to know that there is such case laboratory in Protech IT too. So, as I promised, now there will be a quiz game. So I will pass word to our girls, Anna and Nika.
Huge thanks to our speakers for sharing this useful info with us.
Thanks our participants for staying with us.
So now we're gonna offer you to have some fun and check what you have learned from these lectures.
Hope you don't forget about the quiz.
Well, even if you did, we're going to remind you anyway.
The questions will relate to the materials that were mentioned in the previous lectures.
So, and do you remember how many questions do we have?
Not a lot. There will be several questions that will appear on your screen. And you will have 30 seconds to write your answer in the chat.
And where our participants can find this chat?
Oh, that's a great question. Click a button chat in the conference controls. A chat window will open. You should click the drop-down list next to the two field and choose the name of the specific user that you can see on the screen. You should send message to this user.
So yes, it's basically a piece of cake. Just write to this user and that's it.
Yep, that's easy.
Well, I'm really excited to start.
But at first, we need an easy warm-up.
Oh yeah, that's actually a great idea. Now we're just going to practice, so you can learn how to answer our questions easy and quickly.
We will ask you easy questions not related to the general topic of our session. But pay attention, you will not receive points in this round.
So, ready?
Steady, go! What is the highest mountain in the world?
Oh, actually, I think that's a very easy question.
I also think so. We have a lot of materials, movies, books about this peak.
And I also think that every adventurer dreams about this place.
I think also so. Do you dream about it?
I'm not an adventurer, but if I was, yeah. But we're actually running out of time, so 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, up. Next question. Yeah. How many months have 28 days?
Oh. Do you think is it easy question?
Of course that's an easy question, unless it's a tricky one, but...
Don't give hints, please, actually.
We're here for the fair game, right?
Yeah. Okay. Did you answer? We're waiting for you. Waiting for your answers.
So, the time is almost up. Is it 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and that's it?
Could you write the name of the first human in space?
Oh, that is supposed to be a very easy question.
Do you think so? I think it's easy for the Russian people.
Yes, but our applicants are going to study in Russia. They want to study in Russia. They have to know this.
I think it's a first step to plug in the Russian culture.
It's one of the most important things to know about Russia and the Soviet Union.
Oh, by the way, yes.
And the time is almost up. Yep. It's 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and that's it.
What color you won't see on the Olympic Games rings?
I think this one is a tricky question because you have to remember all other colors before you get this one right.
You are right. By the way, several years ago, Russia accepted the Olympic Games.
Oh, I remember that time. It was pretty fun.
Yeah, it was. And I hope that we will have fun soon because European Football Championship will come soon.
And the time is almost up. So we have 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and that's it. So, and the last question is especially easy one. How many members are there in the Fellowship of the Ring?
Oh, I like this question. I really like it. I'm glad that we add it.
So, what is your favorite movie out of the three?
I think the last one, the third one, because I like the battle in the end. It's great.
And I like the first one, the whimsical feeling of a beginning of an epic journey.
Mm-hmm.
So, and the time is almost up. It's 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and finish.
Great. Hope you like it. I would like to remind you that it was just a practice.
And now we're ready for some serious question.
Yep. That's true. The result of this round will be announced after the session in the end.
And since it's a pretty serious battle, we are not going to distract you. So have some fun with the questions and may the odds be ever in your favor.
Good luck.
Thank you, girls. There were many interesting questions. Hope soon we will know who will be the winner and who will get some presents from our university. So today we will speak a little bit about the opportunities and educational products which our university suggests. But first of all, I will show some introduction video, which was prepared specially for you by our staff, which is not only friendly and helpful, but also creative and inventive.
Hola, amigos. Xin chào.
Ni hao.
Moi, tervetuloa.
Bonjour.
Привітаю. Де гвіт?
Як шамаш? Вітаємо на нашій учельні.
Мархаба.
Hi, friends. I'm glad to see you here. Welcome.
At the first electrotechnical university in Europe, in the city of the White Knights. No. Not like this, but also beautiful.
At the university where you can balance your hobbies and education.
Education to help you gain professional skills and knowledge.
Knowledge that helps you surely move forward to a dream. Let's take care of each other.
Welcome to the electrotechnical university.
So, here we are. And now, about our educational programs. Our university offers different bachelor, master and PhD programs in Russian and English language. And if you want to get education in Russian language, if you are interested in Russian language, so you have to learn it. And we have special preparatory department. There are three profiles: technical, economical and humanitarian. And our basic course lasts from October to June, and the first semester is dedicated only for Russian language. And during the second semester, there will be not only Russian language classes, but other subjects as well, like math, physics, computer science, some social studies, like Russian history and others. And the subjects depend on the chosen profile. The education at our preparatory department is conducted in small groups, and it means individual approach to all students and more conversation practice and full engagement of all students during the educational process. Additionally, our tutor organizes special excursions for students, helps them with their questions and issues during the period of adaptation in a new country. Moreover, our summer and winter schools are free of charge for international students of our preparatory department. And I would like to introduce our manager, Maria. And now I would like to introduce our manager, Maria. Maria, please tell us about the programs which our university suggests.
Thank you, Sandra. Hello, dear applicants. Our university offers bachelor, master and PhD programs in Russian language. If you choose to study at our university, you will have opportunities to apply for the programs of 7 faculties. You can see the faculties on the slide. Faculty of Radio Engineering and Telecommunication, Faculty of Electronics, Faculty of Computer Science, Electrical Engineering Faculty, Faculty of Biotechnical Systems, Management and Economic Faculty, and Faculty of Humanities.
Sounds good. And please tell us how to apply the programs.
Oh, it's a very important question for applicants. Have a look at the next slide. Here you can find out how to apply for the program. At first, of course, you should choose a program. Please read carefully the description of all programs just to be sure that it suits you. If you are interested in computer science or biomedical systems or maybe in linguistics or something like this, then apply for the corresponding programs and faculty. Also, make sure that you submit all the scanned documents before the deadline. After that, you should wait for the confirmation letter. And one another important thing that after you send the document, you will be able to pass online entrance exams, which is required for the enrollment.
And what about accommodation? Do you provide international students with any accommodation?
Oh, yes, of course. And it is an important question for applicants too, I think. And LETI provides housing for all international students. The price for dormitory is quite low. It is about $30 per month. All dormitories are located near metro stations. They are well equipped, safe and comfortable to live in. There are cozy rooms, fitted kitchens, bathrooms, sport rooms, gym and elevators in every hall of residence. Security guards are in dormitories 24/7 and they are in charge that everything is in order there. Every resident has a pass card to get inside the building. And I hope that this information was interesting and useful for you, and see you at LETI.
Thank you so much, Maria. And I would like to add additionally that our tutors organize special excursions for students, help them with their questions and issues during the period of adaptation in a new country, as I have told previously. And ice skating, celebration of Pancake Week or Maslenitsa, as we call it, evening of Oriental poetry, festival of different languages and cultures, and other activities are organized by all our staff. And every year for all international students, we organize excursion to the different world well-known museums, from the Hermitage to Peterhof with its fountains and Tsar's Village, where its famous Amber Room is situated. Also, we organized New Year party in Russian style. Our students from different countries got acquainted with the traditions of celebrating the New Year in Russia. And they learned how to light up the New Year tree and call Ded Moroz. It's Russian version of Santa Claus. And also what movies to watch and what songs to sing on New Year. About songs. We have a cultural center where everyone can find something to enjoy. There are dancing and singing classes, a drama school, and a lot of other classes. So, if you don't mind, I will show you a video of our student and our manager who participate in one of these classes and participates in different university events. Okay, let's continue with the educational program. I hope that you really liked this song from Marina. I would like to introduce Daria. Daria, please welcome. I hope that you all like this video. And now let's continue with our educational programs. And I would like to introduce Daria. Daria, I know that LETI offers some English taught programs. Please tell us a little bit about them.
Hi, dear friends. Today I'm going to present you English taught programs. We are glad to offer you 10 programs, 9 of which are master degree and one program is postgraduate. You can see programs on the slide. Each faculty of the university has one or several programs in English, so you can always choose the one that suits you. During the studies, you will have a unique opportunity to participate in international academic mobility programs at our partner universities around the world. You can join short-term seasonal schools, study semester abroad, participate in double degree programs, and more. Master programs last 4 semesters, which is 2 years. Classes, all of which are taught in English, are provided for 3 semesters. The last semester reserved for practical training, followed by writing and defending master thesis. During the classes for 3 semesters, you will also be provided with Russian language courses, so you will not experience any communication problems in Russia, even if you don't know Russian yet.
How interesting. And Daria, can you tell us how to apply these programs?
Sure thing. To apply, you need to send us the following documents. During admission, we will need the copy of your passport, which should be valid for more than 18 months. Moreover, we will need a copy of your previous diploma and transcript with all assessments. All these documents should be translated into Russian. If you have English translations, you can send it to us and make Russian translations later after you obtain Russian visa, so your name in Russian will be written the same. To prove your English proficiency, you can send us the letter from your previous university. Also, when you come to Russia, we will need documents from the second group. Medical certificates include HIV tests, X-ray, and overall health certificate. All of that can be made in St. Petersburg. Insurance policy, which is also needed, can be made in the university.
Mm-hmm. And what about contacts?
We will be glad to receive your documents via these emails. For Russian taught programs, the documents differ only in Russian language proficiency instead of English. For the preparatory department, no language proficiency needed. We are waiting for your calls via our emails.
And that's all that we wanted to tell you about university and programs in the this introduction webinar. And all contacts and links you can see on the slide. And we're looking forward to welcoming to you in our big family in Russia, in our first electrotechnical university, LETI. Welcome. Welcome, friends.
Thank you.
So we will be glad to see everyone in our university in the future. Bye!